Namaste to all. In this short audio, we will understand a very, very important topic. Of course, this audio will not speak about any of the case details of Aryan Khan, but what is the lesson we can learn from the arrest of Aryan Khan? As a parent, what we can do to secure our child's future or not ending up like an Aryan Khan case? As you would have heard about the case of Aryan Khan, he got arrested when he was traveling in a ship, or he was about to travel in a ship with a group of 7-8 people, where some of the friends of Aryan Khan were using drug. At that point of time when he was arrested, he was not having any drugs with him. Let us, for example, assume, we don't know if Aryan Khan is a drug addict or not, but let us assume that in case if Aryan Khan is not a drug addict, imagine the situation, a person, a child who is not having this kind of bad habit but still getting arrested because of the group of friends he is associated with. This is a really sad state of affairs for any parent. I'm not going to support any parent here. I'm not supporting Shah Rukh Khan or Gauri, etc. The main message is that we could also end up in such a situation in the future where we are bringing up our kids in a good manner and our kid end up in a bad situation like this. So what we as a parent should do to ensure that we are not having this kind of situation in the future? Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati has written a beautiful book called The Light of Truth. In that book, he has given very, very important advices on the upbringing of children. So I am going to give you some tips from the book, which will be very useful, as well as from the tips what I have learned from my Acharya from the website vedmandir.com, as well as from the pravachans of my Acharya whenever I have listened on the topic of upbringing of kids. First and foremost, my Acharya always advises during Upanayan Sanskar and Vedaram Sanskar to all the parents that ensure that your kids do not have bad society. Ensure that all the friends of your kids are having good manners. If they are having bad manners and you find it out, immediately take steps to cut out the friendship. That is what my Acharya always says. So Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati quotes a verse from Shatpat Brahmin Granth, Matriman Pitriman Acharyavan Purusho Veda. A man becomes learned only when he has three proper instructors, mother, father and Acharya. Blessed is that family and the most fortunate is that child whose mother, father are equipped with righteousness and learning. From nowhere do children obtain better advice and more good than from the mother. Therefore, the man is called Matriman who has got a good and virtuous mother. Blessed indeed is the mother who teaches good manners and molds the character of the child from the very day of conception. In fact, my Acharya always says that each and every movement of a mother when she is pregnant affects the child's character in the future. So she has to secure that she is in a good mood, she is doing worship of Almighty God by daily havan, etc., so that the child also learned this kind of sanskar even inside the womb of the mother. Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati further states a very, very important advice to the parents to ensure brahmacharya in the kids, because brahmacharya ashram, the first 25 years or first 30 years before getting married, is so crucial that by maintaining brahmacharya, the kid, number one, achieves long happy life, number two, achieves in healthy life, number three, they will be always happy and they will definitely not go into any bad society for sure. They will get so much of knowledge within themselves due to the power of brahmacharya that they will not fall into this kind of trap. So Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati writes, the mother should always give sound instructions to the children so that they might be refined on manners and might not misuse any of their body parts. The children should not be allowed to touch their reproductive organs, as this habit leads to loss of energizing fluid and also impotency in the future. The parents should inculcate in the children the habit of self-restraint, love of learning and good company. In fact, Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati advises that the parents should shun the vices from the kids, example playing dangerous games. This book is written 200 years back, but today's situation we have heard in the last 3-4 years, there are so many video games and the mobile games which have even resulted in the death of the child. PUBG and various other names I heard recently in the last 2-3 years that many kids had died, they have done suicide, they were forced to do suicide, all those kind of things. And so that as a parents, we should always secure that our kids do not possess a mobile phone But for education purpose, if they are having a mobile phone for doing the, you know, homework, or they have to take online classes, etc., we should secure and we should sit by them and then understand what they are doing. We should not, you know, give them full freedom in using the gadgets, because they could misuse it, because they are very innocent, and in the child, as a child, they do not know what is right and what is wrong. So this has to be very carefully monitored as a parent by us. This is number one shiksha, or number one education, what we have to learn as a parent, that to inculcate brahmacharya in the kids. And for this, my acharya always says that whenever you chant Gayatri mantra, chant any Veda mantra, sit along with your kid in the side, and then teach the mantra to your kid. And whenever you learn any Veda mantra, meaning you teach it to your kid, spend 15 minutes every day, read one or two pages, do swadhyaya, and also explain the Veda mantra meaning to the kid. And by doing this, the kid also gets the interest in the eternal Vedic culture, and they will also grow as a very good man or woman. This is what my acharya always advises. Again, Maharishi Patanjali has written a beautiful book called Mahabhashya. Mahabhashya is a commentary on the Sanskrit book of Panini, Ashtadhyayi, in which Maharishi Patanjali Rishi writes, those mothers, fathers and preceptors, that is Acharya, who maintain a strict discipline over their children and pupils are supposed to be giving nectar to them. On the other hand, those who treat their children or pupil fondingly are in fact ruining them by giving poison. So do not give over affection to the child and do not spoil them. It is like as if you are giving a poison to the child, is what Maharishi Patanjali says. And in fact, we have seen that in our experiences as well, as like people who are hitting the headlines for wrong reasons are definitely those kids who are given excellent love and affection and were never got any strict punishments for any wrongdoing or mischiefs they have done in the childhood. So as a parent, we should always secure that we are ensuring, enforcing discipline in our kids so that their future is secured. And once they learn what is right, what is wrong, once they understand the Vedic education, and once they understand who is Almighty, Almighty God is watching us always, and we should do prayer to Almighty God, we should do righteous things. Once they start understanding this, then we can have a free hand for sure, and they will never do any mistakes after that. That is my guarantee, and I'm sorry, not my guarantee, my experience as well. Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati also says another very, very important thing, the manners, in terms of manners to the kids. In addition to the other teachings, the children should also be told how to avoid stealing and also how to avoid sloth, I mean laziness. You should not be lazy, you should not have pride in you, you should be submissive. Whenever you see an elder, you should give your seat to them, and you should not sit. You should sit down and then the elder should sit in a upper place. You should say namaste to them. You should bow down to them. This kind of good characters and manners we should teach to the young kids. And also we should always teach, do not have violence. Do not practice violence, or do not do evil to others. Do not speak ill of others. These things we should teach to kids, and they will understand better when we practice it at our homes. If we are speaking bad about others in phones to our friends, or mother speaking bad about backbiting others, obviously children also will learn the same thing from the parents. And if we are drinking liquor, we are doing partying, dancing, smoking, drinking liquor, we are coming from late night parties, obviously the kid also watches the father and mother, and then they will also learn the same thing in the future. So this also has to be very clearly followed by the parents, so that the kids are brought up in a very good manner. This is the advice given by Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati. In fact, Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati further says that ingratitude means the negation of the appreciation of the good done by others. So always teach your kids to be grateful. Always teach your kids to be thankful. You also be thankful to others, your kids also will be thankful to others. You also do everyday worship and thank Almighty God, your kid also will do everyday worship and thank Almighty God. So this is what my acharya always says, that when you are not doing worship of Almighty God as per Vedas, you cannot expect your kid to do that. And Maharishi Dayanand Saraswati says that fraud, hypocrisy, ingratitude, they give pain to one's own mind. So when we are getting affected by somebody cheating us, when we are getting affected by somebody doing hypocrisy on us, obviously we should not do these things to others. So this education also has to be taught to the children, that when you are getting affected by other people's behavior, wrong behavior, then you also should not do wrong behavior to others. And in Taittiriya Upanishad, the Acharya who has written Taittiriya Upanishad has given this very good point in the chapter number 8 and verse number 11, that the parents and the Acharya should always impart good advice to the children and pupil, and should also tell them that the children should copy only those actions of them which are righteous, and whatever vicious they find in them, they should shun it. This is the kind of advice a Rishi gives in his textbook. And also Maharishi Dhananda Saraswati says, please teach them Vedic scripts, please teach them Sanskrit, please teach them every day some knowledge so that they can imbibe those good qualities inside them. Spend some time, 15 minutes, half an hour every day, or at least in the weekends, if you are a busy parent, at least in the weekends, sit with them for 1 hour, 1.5 hours, understand their behavior, understand their feelings. Probably they are hiding something from you because they see you as a very strict parent, or you are not understanding in nature. So try to have this dialogue and try to impart the dharma. Dharma is Veda. The Veda knowledge is dharma knowledge. So try to impart the dharma knowledge to the kids so that they will understand. And also, my Acharya always says, when you have a kid, you take the kid to the Gurukul and make a contact with Acharya and make them and do the Upanayan Sanskar or Vedaram Sanskar, etc. to the kid, so that the kid will also have the Sanskar inside them, so that tomorrow they will be God fearing and they will also not go into the bad society. See, one more thing we have to understand here. It is the problem of the parents, number one. The problem of the kid starts at the age of teenage. Aryan Khan is 23 years, but we don't know what happened to him when he was a child. But we have a child in our house, you have a child in your house, we should secure that, okay, we give a proper education, proper manners, proper respect, basically from the Vedas. If we say to our kid that I am saying you do it, may not have an impact. But if you say to the kid that Almighty God says in the Vedas, our Acharya says in the Vedas, so then for sure the kid will obey. This is my personal experience. Then Manusmriti says one should keep one's eyes downwards. So teach the kids to keep the eyes downwards, be submissive. And when walking, the kid should see the ground and walk. He should not see the sky and walk. This kind of basic manners we should teach the kids. And also we should secure that we are giving a proper diet. Vegetarianism should be inculcated in the kids. The kids should be away from violence. For kids should be away from violence, we also should turn vegetarian. Because Almighty God strictly gives strong punishment for people who are eating non-veg food. This I have made several videos, you could see in my other videos in the channel. Then Acharya Chanakya says a very important point. Those parents are perfect enemies of their children who did not give them education. They are disgraced in the society of the learned persons just as a crow in the company of swans. So this education is not only the bhautic education, the materialistic education. This is also the Vedic education, the dharma education. So we have to teach our kids the basics of dharma. We have to teach our kids on how to walk the righteous path. Once we do this, then we can expect our kids turning like Arjuna, kids turning like Sri Ram or Sri Krishna, who were great warriors and who were great learned of Vedas. For sure this will happen in future if we do this kind of habits from the childhood. So these are some of the tips which Maharishi Dhananda Saraswati has given, as well as I have learned from my Acharya. I hope it was helpful to you. I request you to spread this audio video as much as possible. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om.